بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to my channel UHE تجويد Rules of the Quran channel in English. Today إن شاء الله we'll take more details about همزة الوصل and همزة القطع. These details, it will be explaining some stuff in Arabic and some words we saw in the Quran every day maybe or when we read, and we didn't focus how it's become in this shape. So let's go together and see the two kind of condition we will explain today inshallah. شاهد الجزرية for the chapter of همزة الوصل and همزة القطع total. وابدأ بهمز الوصل من فعل بضم إن كان ثالث من الفعل يضم واكسره حال الكسر والفتح وفي الأسماء غير اللام كسرها وفي ابن مع ابنتي امرئ واثنين وامرأة واسم مع اثنتين. We explain every single word in these lines already, and we explained it the haraka, we explained the haraka in the beginning of verbs, we explained the haraka in the beginning of al ta'rif, we explained the haraka in the beginning of all the nouns. Today inshallah we will go through more details like I told you, and we will see the Quran has hamzat wasl and hamzat qata in the same word. When we find the hamzat wasl and hamzat qata in the same word, there is two cases we can see this kind of two hamza in row. We can find it in hamzat al-wasl before hamzat al-qata. Okay, this is number one. Or this is come in verbs only. Or we can find hamzat al-qata, which is we use it in this case to ask a question, before hamzat al-wasl, and we can find it in verbs and nouns. We will go through every one of these and we will take details. So we will go through number one, hamzat al-wasl before hamzat al-qata, sakina, and we will see it in verbs, and then we will go through hamzat al-qata when we use it to ask a question, and when it's come before hamzat al-wasl in the verbs first, and then we'll see it in the nouns. Let's go together and see it inshallah. Number one, hamzat al-wasl before hamzat al-qata in verbs only. The rules for it is, if we connecting it will be different than if we start with. Let's go together and see. If we connecting, we drop hamzat al-wasl like normal and read hamzat al-qata only sakina. If we starting, we read hamzat al-wasl and we start with the same haraka of third letter, we change hamzat al-qata to a mad letter. This mad letter can go with the haraka of hamzat al-wasl and we call it qa'idat al-badal. Let's go together and see the details of each part. Let's see when we are connecting, how we drop hamzat al-wasl and read hamzat al-qata. This is in special verbs, which is utumina, أوتمينا، إيتوني، إيذن. I want to look in these three verbs. I have همزة وصل followed it همزة قطع. This is همزة وصل and it's followed by همزة قطع. همزة وصل followed by همزة قطع. همزة وصل followed by همزة قطع. Remember, همزة القطع, it's any همزة. It's any root همزة. You can see it in ألف, you can see it in واو, you can see it in يا, you can see it online. So any kind of hamza you can see in front of you, and it's wrote clear, like hamza, we call it hamza qatr. So I have here hamza wasl, followed it hamza qatr. Wasl followed it hamza qatr. Wasl followed it hamza qatr. When I connect, I will drop this hamzat wasl and I will read hamzat qat'a. So I will go from the last letter of the word before to this hamza. Last letter from the word before to this hamza. Last letter from the word before to this hamza. We'll see this in the Quran right now. Here, الَّذِي تُمِنَ. الَّذِي تُمِنَ. Okay. فَإِنْ أَمِنَ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا فَلْيُؤَدِّ الَّذِي اؤْتُمِنَ أَمَانَتَهُ. الَّذِي اؤْتُمِنَ. So I will go from ذَلْ كَسْرَة to هَمْزَة سُكُون right away. What about this ya? I will drop it because there is التقاء ساكنين here. And the همزة الوصل, I drop it during the connecting. Next example here, وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ اُؤْتُونِي بِكُلِّ سَاحِرٍ عَلِيمٍ. فِرْعَوْنُ, فِرْعَوْنُ اُؤْتُونِي. Clear, inshallah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ ذَلِّي, لُؤْذَلِّي. Clear, inshallah, clear for you. This is from Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 283. Surah Yunus, verse 79. Surah At-Tawbah, verse 49. This is when we connect. When we start, we read Hamzat al-Wasl and we start with the same haraka of third letter. We change Hamzat al-Qat' to a mad letter. This mad letter can go with the haraka of Hamzat al-Wasl and we call it Qa'idat al-Badal. قاعدة البدل, I explained it before in the chapter of Mudud with a lot of details and with the all words for it in the chapter of Mudud. You can back for it and watch it. Inshallah, I will put it for you as a recommendation video in the end of the video, in the end of that video. Let's see here the details about these three words in the Quran. How we start with it. Let's go right now and explain a little bit how can we start with this verb. Verb utumina. We have hamzat wasl here coming before hamzat qata, right? So we know how we want to know how we start with it. When starting, first step, we read Hamzat al-Wasl and we start the same haraka of third letter. That means I will read this Hamza. What's the haraka of the third letter here? What's the haraka of third letter here? This is Hamzat al-Wasl. What's the haraka of the third letter here, which is Dhamma, right? We read Hamzat al-Wasl and we start with the same haraka of third letter. Then, how can we read Hamzat al-Wasl? We will start with the same haraka of third letter, which is Dhamma. So, I will have U. It will be like Hamza now, right? What's my second step? The word is coming like that right now. What's my second step? Let's see together. What's my second step? Okay. It changed Hamzat al-Qata to mad letter. Change Hamzat al-Qata to mad letter. How can I know which mad letter I will put? This made the letter should to go with the haraka of Hamzat al-Wasl. Right now, Hamzat al-Wasl, I have Dhamma on top of it. Dhamma is a daughter of what? Of Waw. Then I will change Hamzat al-Qata, this one, to be a mad letter. This mad letter go with that Dhamma, which is Waw. Ooh. Tumina. Tumina. Then how can I read with this word? With Dhamma of Hamzat al-Wasl. And I will change the Hamzat al-Qat' to mad letter. It can work with Dhamma, which is Waw. Tumina. فَلْيُؤَدِّ الَّذِي تُمِنَ أَمَانَتَهُ. How can I start with it? تُمِنَ أَمَانَتَهُ. Inshallah, this point is clear and easy. Why we call it قاعدة البدل? Because it's follow right now the number one, we change this letter to be mad letter. We change Hamzat al-Qata' to be a mad letter. Number two, right now I have a mad badal here. Hamza followed by mad letter. Mad badal to haraka. Tumina. Let's see this. How it will be. It will be from alladhi tumina. When I start, it will be tumina. Utumin if I stop. Inshallah, this is clear for this word. Let's go for the next word and see the, we said it's a three words total. Let's go for the next word and see how it will be in the Quran and how can we read it. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ ذَلِّي وَلَا تَفْتِنِّي. يقول. This is if I connect. How can I start with this word if I start from it? Let's go together and see. I have Hamzat Wasl before Hamzat Qata. Okay. Number one, we read Hamzat al Wasl and we start with the same haraka of third letter. Then the word in front of me here. Let's go ahead. We read Hamzat al-Wasl and we will look for the third letter haraka. Okay. And we will follow the qa'ida of verbs. If the third letter of verb has fatha, then I start with what? Hamzat al-Wasl start with what? With kasra. Then it will be kasra here. This is number one. Second step. What's my second step here? It change Hamzat al-Qata to a mad letter. This mad letter can work with the haraka of Hamzat al-Wasl. I have Kasra on Hamzat al-Wasl here. Then what's the mad letter can go with Kasra? I have Hamza Kasra here. I want to change this Hamzat Qata to be a mad letter, which is E, yeah. Because yeah is the mom of the kasra, then it will be e then. E then. Then if I want to start with it, I will say e thenly. Inshallah, clear this point too. Let's go together and see our next word. قَالُوا اتِنَا بِعَذَابِ اللَّهِ. And I give you another example. فِرْعَوْنُ اتُونِي بِكُلِّ سَاحِرٍ, for example. Let's go together and see how can I start with this word. How can I start with it? We have Hamzat Wasl here before Hamzat Qata in one word. And number one, we read Hamzat al-Wasl. Okay, What's the حركة في همزة الوصل? To read it, I will look for the third letter, which is كسرة. So همزة الوصل here, it should to be what? همزة كسرة. E, right? The word here. Let's make it clear here. So what's the حركة of همزة الوصل here? It will be كسرة. E, E. Second step, I need to change the همزة القطع, this one, to be a مد letter. This مد letter is for is work with a حركة of مد of همزة الوصل. حركة of همزة الوصل is كسرة. مد letter it can work with كسرة, which is yeah right away. Then it will be instead of this همزة. I will put it here. E. E Tina. E Tony. And so on. Okay. So how can I start with it again? E Tina or E Tony in the other verse. Okay. Inshallah, this point is clear for you. We call it قاعدة البدل because we change the همزة القطع to مد letter. And in this case, I have همزة كسرة يسكون after it, which is مد بدل already. E, two beats. Okay, inshallah clear for you this point. جزاكم الله خيرا. To watch my channel QHE تجويد rules of the Quran channel in English. See you inshallah in the next video when we talk inshallah about همزة القطع when it's before همزة الوصل. What we will do and how can we pronounce it and what's the حركة or if there is no حركة. We'll see all the details next time inshallah. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.